the playoffs every year?
Well, you know what? Times are changing, buddy.
Okay. Yeah, you can spend some more money.
Hi, I'm Jason Twaddell.
And I'm Kris Carlsson.
And we're from Ball Flora Plant, and we're here at Van de Wettering Greenhouses to bring to you a four-part series of videos on how to be a baseball fan for a team that never makes it to the World Series.
No, it's a propagation video.
Oh.
So we're here to help you grow the best liner that you can every time you stick a cutting. It's a four-part series on how to grow a better liner. Let's get started. Hey, this video is all about planning, preparing, and receiving. This is kind of the spring training of baseball for your cuttings. So the goal here is to shorten the time from the box to the bench. I'm going to say that again, it's really important. Shorten the time from the box to the bench. It's all about planning. You need to know how many cuttings are coming on the given week and what days are going to come. You need to know that. You need to know exactly how many are coming so you can prepare enough trays and have enough space to get all those cuttings stuck. Now we need to prepare. Where do you need to prepare? You need to prepare in your propagation house. Have you checked all your heaters? Are they all working correctly? Have you checked all the mist nozzles? Are they all working correctly? And have you cleaned them recently before the season? Also, you need to clean out all the filters and anything else that's going to help that propagation zone run better. Now we need to talk about sanitation. Before the cuttings arrive, you need to have your sanitation protocols in place. Clean all the floors, all the benches, get rid of all the weeds. Make sure everything's clean and prepared for those cuttings to arrive. And in between weeks and mid-season, you need to sanitize those benches and walkways again to make sure you're still clean for when those cuttings arrive. The next step is to prepare your workers. You can see them behind me. You need to train them. Make sure you have enough people to stick all the cuttings. You need to let them know how deep the cutting should be stuck. You need to make sure they're going to tag it appropriately. And finally, should they use rooting hormone or not? So now the cuttings are here. We've planned, we've prepared, now we've received. We need to go to Jason and look at what you should do with your cuttings once you've received them.
For part two of our first video, we're going to talk about controlling the environment of our cuttings, because now they've arrived. So you can see here, we're in this cooler at Van de Wettering Greenhouse. I got my hat on, I got my vest on. It's nice and cold in here. We're trying to keep the right environment for our cuttings now that they've arrived. We want to do that until we can get them out to the sticking line, get them stuck into the greenhouse. So what is the ideal environment? The ideal environment is 50 to 55 degrees for the vast majority of our cuttings and high humidities. We want to maintain a nice turgid cutting until we can get it stuck. There are a few outliers from that temperature range. So geraniums, chrysanthemums, there's a couple of crops that could be run a little bit colder, close to 40. Most of our crops, 50 to 55 works really well for our Ball Flora Plant catalog. There's a couple of items like purslane, basil, sweet potato. Those like to be a little bit warmer, 55 to 60 degrees. So make sure you've got your cooler ready when those cuttings arrive and you get them into this nice environment so you can store them appropriately and they're in good shape when they go to the sticking line. The other part of the environment is the humidity. You can wet down your floors or you can put wet newspaper on top of your cuttings. You can see some lantana cuttings here from Nicaragua. You can put a wet newspaper right on top of them to help them maintain that turgid cutting until you can get it stuck. It's one thing to remember that your cooler can be a really dry environment. So that's why we do need to talk about humidity as well. The second part of handling and storing our cuttings appropriately is sanitation. That's why I'm wearing this apron and these gloves. So there's two parts of sanitation that are very important. First part is barriers, like an apron or gloves. You can give your workers these barriers to make sure that they do the right sanitation practices for handling your cuttings. And the second part is sanitizers, like hand sanitizer or some kind of sanitizing agent that they can use for their hands in between each box that they open. The other thing to think about too is sanitizing your carts, your trays, anything that is used to handle or store the cuttings. For part three of our first video, we're going to talk about prioritizing and grouping our cuttings for success. So when your cuttings come in and you're sorting them out, there's a few items that are very high sensitivity items. Ones that don't hold up well under stress. This is one of those items, lantana. It came in from our farm in Nicaragua. The team here at Vander Wettering is going to be sticking these cuttings very soon. Those came in today. They're going to get them stuck same day. Make sure that they're at the top of their priority list. Geraniums, Dumbergia, Purslane, those are all crops that can fit on that high sensitivity, high priority part of your list. If you need a list, you can go to our Ball Floor Plant website in the culture section and find our list so you can use it for building your own priorities. The other thing we want to do is group our cuttings for success. So once you get your cuttings sorted out, put them into groups that are high miss requirements or low miss requirements or crops that are longer rooters or shorter rooters. This is important because as you want to wean your cuttings off of miss later on in your production cycle, we're going to talk about this in the next video, in the third video. You want to make sure you're weaning these off together. So put those miss requirements together to group them for success in propagation. So now that we've talked about all of our different aspects of how to prepare and plan and receive our cuttings, we're going to talk about some of the biggest mistakes that are made in this part of it. And speaking of big mistakes, we've got Kris Carlsson, a resident Oakland A's fan here at Ball Floor Plant.
How many times have the Royals made the playoffs in the last few years? Oh, that's right, not very many. The A's seem to make it pretty much every year. So when we talk about big mistakes, a failure to plan is a plan to fail, right? That's what we talked about in the prep and all the things of getting your workers ready, the zone ready, and we want to shorten that time from the box to the bench.
Correct. Correct. The other thing we want to remember is that we want to have the right environment for these cuttings when they come in. So you want to store them in your cooler in the right environment with the proper temperature and proper humidity so that you can maintain a nice turgid cutting until
75
you get it stuck.
Degrees, right?
75 would be a little warm, I think. I think let's shoot for 50 to 55.
Sounds good. So then the last section is to group and prioritize your cuttings. You want to get your lantanas stuck first, your geraniums stuck first, group your coleus together so when it's time to get them off the mist, you're weaning them, all your groupings off mist together.
You're right, that's absolutely right. And remember, no matter how much you plan or prepare, if you're an Oakland A's fan, you're going to be disappointed at the end of the season.
Yes, I'm
so that you can get the crops to specific to that. So the lady's in the back. I can't say so.
See if you can hit my curveball. You bump.
Come on, old man, you probably got a Greg Maddux arm.
Yeah. I'm uncomfortable.